Hey everybody, it's Justin from J3 Creations, and today I'm going to be tying up a mandala on this little onesie. So I'm going to start by pulling out the front, and then I'm right now trying to get this tiny little sleeve through the other tiny little sleeve and make sure that all the lines are lined up so that I get a nice symmetrical design. I'm going to start right here, and that'll probably be, midway for the kid as well. So, it'll be a nice mandala. I'm going to attempt to make sure that my folds are as flat and good as possible. And I'm just going to do an 8-point mandala on this little guy. Don't really want to try and stretch it as far as getting a 16-point mandala on there. I'm sure it's possible, but I don't really want to mess with that today. Looks like I should have had the sleeve pushed out the other way, but that's whatever. One more fold, and that'll be the 8-point mandala. I'm going to get a rubber band on here just to hold things in place. So you want to make sure that your folds are lined up as perfect as you can get them. Mine aren't too perfect, but it'll work. So I've got some sinew here. I'm going to get a little slip knot. Man, sometimes it's easier to tie these than others. Okay, so we're just going to slip the sinew right over there and pull that tight, and that'll be the first line on your mandala. And wrap it a couple times and pull tight, and I'm just gonna do a zigzag pattern because that's my favorite. So I pull it tight, keep tension on the line, wrap it a couple of times, and pull. So again, just wrapping it at an angle and pulling it. Then we'll go another zig in the zag. And again, it's good to keep tension on it the whole time. And then pull. Just a couple of wraps and pull. And you want to do that so that it locks the sinew in each time. If you do, 5 to 10 wraps and then pull, then you'll end up with some sinew that is unraveled. Got a homemade sinew wrapper. It's actually a piece of beech wood that I found. Kind of proud of it. So you can see I'm just kind of going back and forth here. Nothing too spectacular, but it'll create a fun design. So, right about here, we'll get you a mandala just on the front of the onesie. I'm going for a mandala on the entire onesie. And so this will get the front onesie, front part of the onesie, and this will do the back part. And so I'm going to take the rubber band off and send you the back part for now, but you can have the freedom to leave it on just the front if you'd like, or continue to go on the back. It's entirely up to you. You are the artist. So I appreciate you guys for watching, and feel free to comment and ask questions. Please subscribe so you can get all my updates. Managed to fit one more little zigzag on my pattern. So here it is, folks. Just a little baby mandala onesie. So here's the results of the onesie mandala. I was not able to record the dyeing process or the washing process, but this is the final result. You can see that the white lines came out clean and crisp. The mandala didn't do the effect all the way around quite like I wanted, especially here on the bottom, but I think it turned out good enough. I think I learned some things in the process. I think that ice dyeing would be a good way to go to get better saturation for your colors. But overall, it was a good experience, and I'm happy with the end result, and I'm sure that the people will be happy, and the little baby will be happy. So thanks for joining me, and God bless.